Adiom. Hi, everyone. My name is Zach. Welcome back for more Hatha tips. And today we'll be talking about the Hariom mantra, which if you have taken integral yoga classes or perhaps visited an integral yoga center, you very likely have heard this mantra, Hariom. And so why do we chant this mantra? What is the purpose of this? There are many reasons, and we probably won't have time to mention all of them right now, but most fundamentally, there can be a vibrational effect from these mantra. These are ancient acoustical tools used to raise the energy in your own body, to enhance the energy of the space, and to bring a little more joy and lightness into your being. And so specifically, let's do an experiment if you're at home. I am a big fan of trying things out and seeing how they feel. So if you put your hand on your abdomen and say the syllable ha, 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 you'll notice that the abdomen contracts, that this is the part of the body that is engaged when that syllable is said, ha. If you move your hand to the upper chest and the throat area and say ri, 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 you can feel that area vibrating. So the vibration has moved from the stomach up through the chest and the base of the throat. And if you put your hand on the top of your head and say om, om, especially with the mmm, you can feel that vibration at the crown of your head. And so when you put it all together, ha, ri, om, you're physically moving the vibration from the abdomen up through the chest and the throat into the head and out from the top of the head. And when you do this over and over, a beautiful, almost orchestra-like sensation moves through your body. And there's a very uplifting sensation. It doesn't have to sound really abstract or celestial or something. Again, I recommend trying it out and seeing how you feel. When you do it with others, there's a real harmonizing effect. Anytime you chant or sing, they've shown in studies that the left and right hemispheres of the brain have much more synergy and are much more balanced. And so those are some very quick and basic reasons why we chant the Hari Om chant. I guess the last thing to mention is that Swami Satchidananda has mentioned before that Hari Om is a very preferred mantra for him because there's no deity attached to it, pertaining to a particular religious point of view or spiritual path, which may limit some people or keep out other people. Hari Om is purely vibrational, omni-vibrational. And so all are welcome. It's universal. And I recommend you try it out. It can be rather contagious after you get started. So I hope this has been helpful. And I hope if you have further questions about this topic or other topics, you reach out to us and we will be happy to assist you and offer more information as best as we can. Thank you very much. Om Shanti, Hari Om.